Now, one survey finds 85% of large American corporations already offer birth control coverage. Many of the companies objecting to it would be smaller, family-owned businesses.
KCRA3's David Bienick has been talking to one of those owners today about how these cases could affect him very directly.
Yeah, Edie, this particular Sacramento-area company was also active involved in trying to keep in place the Prop 8 ban on same-sex marriage. Well, now the owner, who describes himself as a devout Catholic, is taking on the Affordable Health Care Act with the same religious conviction.
At three locations in the Sacramento area, Leatherby's Creamery offers ice cream for its customers and for the past 15 years has offered health insurance for its more than 100 full-time workers.
I'm an advocate for medical coverage for everybody.
But owner Alan Leatherby says he does not consider contraception and abortion to be medical and so does not believe his company should have to include those services in its insurance coverage.
To have to provide, you know, what we consider, you know, killing a child is horrifying. And to be mandated to do that, I just don't believe that's what our country was founded on.
The Pacific Justice Institute of Sacramento filed a brief with the Supreme Court in support of allowing businesses to opt out of the contraception coverage. And the head of the institute is thrilled that the court has decided to hear two related cases.
It shows that the Supreme Court takes it very seriously. And so they're not kicking the can on this case. They're going to be addressing it head on.
Supporters of the contraception requirement say it was unfair to let insurance cover things like Viagra for men, but not birth control for women. And they say that even before the Affordable Care Act took effect, most insurance companies were already offering contraception coverage as a way to keep costs down. Ellen Leatherby confirms it's been harder and harder to find insurance plans that don't offer contraception coverage, and one of the two plans he currently offers does in fact include it. Still, he doesn't like the government telling him he has to.
And now to be mandated that we have to do that is disturbing.
Leatherby says fortunately for him, the part of the health care law that applies to small businesses like his has been put on hold for an extra year. The earliest he could start having to offer contraception coverage would be January 2015. And in the meantime, we're going to hear from the court and probably have a ruling.
David, thank you.